She's going to represent the European Commission. She's a program officer from the DG Connect. In fact, I would like to remind that Open Care is a project funded by the European Commission. And Loretta is going to tell us why the Commission decided to support a project like this. And also, she's going to give some elements about a brand new project developed by the European Commission called Next Generation Internet.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. So, mi chiamo Loretta Nania. Sono italiana. Quante persone non capiscono l'italiano? How many do not understand Italian? 3. Okay, I could speak either language. So let me introduce myself first. So my mother was a Montessori teacher. So I finished school by 17 and entered university in the UK because in Italy you had to be at least 6 to enter first grade and at least 18 to enter university. And I took exams as privatista, but those rules have changed. I also entered the UK with liras in my pockets. You couldn't export lira at the time. When I had to pay my fees, it was 3 times the UK students. I was a foreigner. So the reason I say that is now I see, perhaps with Brexit, that we're going to go back to a framework where you don't have the euro, you don't have a common currency, you don't have students going everywhere with Erasmus. Erasmus is one of our best projects because it allows students to travel and learn from each other. So my first slide, one other thing is I went to MIT, got a PhD there, and I was lucky to work on the internet, which at the time was a new project. I was in the DARPA, and I remember the very first IBM machines. When I joined the commission, and I joined the commission because I believe in research, and I believe in broadband networks. So I'm very happy when I read in Corriere della Sera that Enel is now investing in open fiber. Stockholm has invested also in dark fiber, and for about the first 10 years in the commission, I was funding broadband applications, looking at cost benefit. Things don't change that fast. We are still looking at the cost benefit of broadband, but I'm a broadband enthusiast. I'm also an enthusiast about research. And in 27 years, I funded a lot of projects. And currently, I have a lot of projects in Milan because Milan has been very successful in leading the way in projects on smart cities. And in this case, I'm going to talk to you about social innovation. Social innovation and citizen engagement. These are the keys for the future, for the reform of healthcare and other digital welfare services. The European story since 1957 in Rome, the treaties, is unity and diversity. It's easier said than done. You all have to take your part and vote for these things, all of these good things. So sustainability is the one that the CAPS project, which was mentioned by the earlier speaker, that is a project where the Commission has invested 70 million worth of research. We currently have something like 54 projects. Open Care is one of them. All of these projects are doing what some national programs, such as the one in Portugal, does, which is to mix things such as Fab Labs, hackers, movements, open source, and NGOs, civil society. So the key word is that in my previous projects, before I worked on CAPS, I was doing a lot with SIPA, with Orange Telecom, with IBM, but not with civil society organizations, which is a shame because my father, when he worked at FAO and United Nations, World Bank, he created COPAC. The A is for agriculture, the C is for capital funding. So in the first question on your agenda, what do you need for open models? Well, cooperatives have always existed. They are not new. What is new is the technology that supports movements of people and also new institutions. So it's institution building that is really the focus of these programs, which start from research. Something about the EU in these days. The Nobel Prize, thanks to 70 years of lasting peace, which should not be taken for granted. There are indicators. You are researchers, so you know about indicators. So some of the most peaceful countries are part of the Union. So let's strengthen peace and strengthen unity and diversity. Then we go more into the distribution of resources, income, taxes. And it turns out Europe is home to the most equal societies in the world. This is the OECD. And now I get to my little Horizon 2020, which, as I said, I came to work on FP2. I had the very first memo project, digital audio broadcasting. These are technology-driven broadband applications. The first framework program was all about IT. This was Olivetti, Siemens, Bull. I could go through many, many industries in Europe completely disappeared. We now have a situation, platforms was what we are going to talk about, where I think there is like two companies that own something like 70 to 80% of the data in Europe. The situation is less monopolistic in the US. And so all of our projects are trying to build choices. They are small, they use open source hardware and like Arduino, if you know, or a Raspberry Pi. They all use open source software, which means that they don't own it. They put it under a private license, under an open source license for reuse. So the reuse and the constant innovation is part of the process that is now called digitalization. There's also AI, robotics, and other things. So Horizon 2020, our budget was approved for FP9. Which is the one that follows Horizon 2020, was approved just 2 days ago. So I was happy. It looks like a big number. Then I looked at agriculture. It's 5 times as much as research. I read today that 30% of the public Italian researchers are precari. You cannot, I mean, we are also some of the oldest researchers in the world. So again, a plea for research budgets. It's very hard to get into CAPS. Open Care was one of them. For every project we funded, we had like 19 who didn't get funded. So although my budget, when I talk 70 million, seems huge, there's about 20 times as many little civil society organizations, fab labs, hackers forums that would like to change the world and would like to be given a chance. So some of you are very lucky, you know, you work hard. Whoops. What happened here? Electricity, it's energy moving to broadband. So, CAPS has 40 projects, and they're all about, in fact, when I speak, if you have a smartphone, you can look at collective awareness, just 2 words. If you put it in a search engine, you will get all of the projects. Okay, collective awareness. And, we had the last call, and I finished 2 negotiations. They're all going to start 1st of January. We have 10 more projects to add. So all of them are about sustainable development. It turns out that of the DG Connect budget, at the time, only 16% was devoted to sustainable development. That's too little. Sustainable development is actually one of the biggest. I'm enthusiastic about the 17 Sustainable Development Goals. I was hoping that all the CAPS projects would be able to use the same indicators because the main point to make is that those 17 goals are related. Let me give you an example. If in Africa you fund women, you will also reduce births and reduce poverty. So you cannot just do programs that ignore women. You know, you have to, and I can talk about water or air. They're all related. It's an ecosystem. So I think there's a lot of work that went into those 17 sustainable goals. The Commission is really doing a big part in the environmental area, for example. There are two areas we are less good at. One is poverty reduction, and the other one is number five, is women's issues. So citizen engagement is what it's all about, okay? Citizen engagement through platforms. One of the projects that I had called WebCozy managed to get 1.5 million citizens involved on its platforms. This is nothing compared to 3.5 billion that plug into Facebook every day, but still, so our projects are small and fragmented. But some of them, and this was the one that reached the most people, some of them do actually get very strong local support. And it all starts from the local. Having the support of the Milan administration, and in fact having the Comune signing our contracts, is astounding. It's for me, I mean, it's an incredible. When I first started, it would take like 6 months to get any public museum, whatever, to even give you an answer on a contract. So our projects are really, the Americans say, on the ball. You really have to deliver quickly. So yes, citizen engagement, social innovation is now the buzzword. It fits in all of these DGs. We're going to have a big conference just in 2-3 days in Lisbon. Lisbon has a program, national program, that is just like CAPS. It has similar projects, started a few years ago. And all of my projects are together doing a session on digital welfare. How do you continue to support welfare at a time when we are shrinking resources? You actually need the digital platforms. And I just wanted to make sure that although the words are the same, the citizen, the user, the citizen is cast in different roles. As in the media, it's the audience. It's the creative artist, the consumer, curious, decision maker, funder, observer. Active and passive and everything in between. And on active and passive, as a European, I don't like to just consume. I don't like to consume media. I think we should also produce. Now, in terms of art, culture, music, there's nothing to be said. I mean, but with the digital, we need to also produce in that digital environment. This doesn't necessarily mean IPRs or limited. You can actually thrive in other ways, and these are the new economic models that some of the projects are doing. Now this is actually my future. This was the new, CAPS is finished. We had 3 or 4 calls. It's now being funded through other DGs now that we have prepared the technology and the organization. This is the new program. So next year I will be funding projects in this. So I'm actually going back to funding internet technology projects. Why the internet? Because of those ethical, political, privacy, and trust issues that I mentioned. I think Europe has to be producing as well as consuming. And the EU is there to support you. Things are not easy. The EU has to be seen now in a changing place, in an evolving world. So the economic weight is going down. Others are going up. There are defense priorities, the so-called Macron budget. There's the agriculture budget, I mean, I mentioned it before. And there's my research budget. But for this project on open care, the most important thing has to do with population shift. Okay, this, and also the recomposition of families. Changing. So collectively, we have to be aware of how profoundly changed is our economy and society. We come out of a crisis. The demographic problem is astounding. With an aging society and youth not working because there are no jobs, there can be no welfare like we had it after the war. So we have to be creative. There is also national borders and security. And there's a questioning of trust and legitimacy. When people do not vote, when more than half, when there's the party of non-voters is bigger than the party of voters, you have problems of democratic legitimacy. Hence, citizen engagement. The way ahead, I'm finished now. These are just my own calendars. As I mentioned, we will have the next calls on those topics to reinforce the internet. The last calls of CAPS have been done, so we are now going to start seeing the results. In this moment, we have at least 54 trials covering all sorts of areas, and you will find out more about open care. And yes, finally, new elections. Everything changes. That's it. There's a lot of, this is the new, our new website. And actually, if I can take questions, perhaps at some other time or later, I'd be very happy. Thank you very much.